Op Glory 86 vecht Benjamin Arik Bouyi tegen Soufiane Laidouni in een kwalificatiegevecht voor de Grand Prix later dit jaar. Wij zochten Benjamin op in zijn appartement in Papendrecht om met hem te gaan trainen in de sportschool van Rico en Dennis Crowell Superpro.
Mr. Gentleman, Benjamin Arik Bouyi!
Preparation is always good, you know. It's not so easy because I always stay away from home, you know. I'm like living in an apartment 3 weeks, one month, 1.5 months, depends on the fight and how important it is, you know. But yeah, I already got used to it, and I already, you know, I know I need to be away from home. I need to train hard, you know, focus, eat good, sleep well, and that's it, you know. And yeah, this time preparation is perfect. Everything is on track, you know. I not been fighting for more than 5 months, so I'm hungry to prove that. Yeah, you know, I believe I belong to the top. I almost always come here because, you know, they have a big condominium with a lot of apartments, and I go online, I check if it's anything available. I rent an apartment for 1 month, 1.5 months, and almost it's more than 4 years that I'm still coming at the same place, because you know what, Super Pro Sports Center is close, Lima is in Rotterdam also close, so you know, I'm in the middle, I just drive with the BMW, you know, 20 minutes and that's it, you know. Man, to be honest, it's really hard, you know. I have a son, he's 7. This moment right now, you know, I had a car accident and my wife is still recovering. We had a bad accident and she needed surgery with a titanium plate inside. So yeah, it's hard, but when you're a professional, you need to focus on what you need to do. And this moment, I need to beat this guy, qualifying the tournament and try to win the tournament. And yeah, you know, my mind is 100% here. I focus, even though it's hard, you know. Yeah, we speak on the phone, I speak my son, he's good, school is good. I have a new gym in home, Benefight Academy, it's running okay, people are close to me. So yeah, I try to, you know, forget all the things and focus on what I have to do, you know. And that's winning in Germany. So yeah, it's pretty simple. Ready to go training, like I do every day, 2 times a day. So yeah, let's go. Everybody knows the Dutch kickboxing style, and not only the Dutch kickboxing, because we have, as Romanians, we have very, very good kickboxing also. But to be honest, as heavyweight, I don't have really a lot of training partners as big as me and as strong as me. And I'm here, Rico is in the gym, helped me a lot. A lot of other boxers come. Tom Aspinall come from Holland, from England, and we train together. He's a top UFC guy, you know. So there are different levels. I can stay in shape in Romania, but I prefer every time when I have a very important fight, come to Holland. Dennis is one of the best trainers in the world, you know. Rico helps me a lot. The other trainers, partners help me a lot. So it's a little bit different, you know. So I prefer to do this and, you know, stay away from home, I don't know, 1 month, 2 months, but still, yeah, do it very professional. So it is what it is. Sleep, eat, grocery, restaurants, it's perfect, man. Not too much distraction because, you know, we are professional fighters. So if I had a club here, it was bad. But, you know, I only have what I need, you know, so. I can focus, I can read. When I'm tired of reading, I watch, I don't know, Netflix or something online, you know. So, yeah. Train 2 times a day, watch my opponent on, you know, on laptop, and that's it.
Ja, Rico, jouw teammaatje die gaat straks op Glory 86 vechten tegen Laidouni. Jij weet als geen ander hoe het met hem gaat. Hoe gaat het met hem?
Ja, Benny gaat heel goed. Kijk, het is altijd vervelend natuurlijk om terug te komen na een verlieswedstrijd. En dus mentaal geeft dat ja, geeft dat altijd even een dipje. Maar ja, zoals wij als team altijd achter elkaar staan, helpen we elkaar er ook weer uit. En hij zit er fantastisch in. Hij zit er, ja, weet je, ik zie hem bezig. Hij is fit. Hij is mentaal weer klaar voor. Hij heeft er weer zin in. Dus ja, ik kan niet anders zeggen dat ik super trots ben en er echt naar uitkijk.
Ja, op welke manier heb jij samen met Dennis hem geholpen na het verlies?
Nou, hoe help je elkaar na een verlieswedstrijd? Ja, dat blijft. Het komt met kleine dingen. Snap je? Een berichtje. Ja, gewoon erbij zijn. Als iemand even zijn hoofd naar beneden. Hé, hou je hoofd omhoog. Weet je? Dus ja, het is sowieso geen schande om te verliezen. Je staat niet tegen de eerste, de beste. Ja, het blijft een gevecht. Dus het is altijd van, hey, wie raakt wie en wie gaat er winnen? Dus het blijft altijd spannend. En zeker in de zwaargewichtdivisie. En daarom denk ik ook dat onze divisie altijd het leukste is om naar te kijken. Want ja, de fight ain't over till it's over. Dus dat maakt het spannend. Dus daarom zeg ik, ben super trots dat hij nu terugkomt. Sterker dan ooit. En gewoon weer deze wedstrijd gaat winnen.
What were your thoughts on the Grand Prix that's coming up? Let me say like this. I'm already 9 years in glory, you know. I fought the best. I fought tournaments. I fought everybody. I fought Rico. I fought Bader. My motivation was like a little out, man, to be honest, you know. I'm old. I'm not 24 years again. And I was like, and when glory announced 8-man tournament, like the old time, and a lot of people still think like the old K1 days, like 8-man tournament, end of the year, who's the best? My motivation came back, you know, and I was like, whoa, I need to win this. And back on track, immediately, no other thoughts, just training hard, try to show the people I'm one of the best in the world.